वंदेहं श्री गुरु श्री जुता पदकमलं
माय ऑथोरिटी इज वैदिक लिटरेचर You will find Bhagavad Gita. You have seen our book, Bhagavad Gita?
Yeah, we have it at the office.
There are description of these things.
Mm-hmm.
There is description of another nature which is called spiritual nature. This is material nature.
Mm-hmm.
The sky, as far as you can see, this is one universe.
Mm-hmm.
Similarly, there are millions of universes. And all these together, that is material sky. Beyond that, there is spiritual sky, which is far, far greater than this. And there are spiritual planets. So this information we have got from Bhagavad Gita.
Mm-hmm.
What to speak of other basic literature? Bhagavad Gita, it is daily read by practically all over the world, but they do not understand it. The simply become student of Bhagavad Gita, or simply just to think falsely that I am God, therefore. They don't take any particular information. There is a verse in the 8th chapter, Parastasmātu bhāvanyam bhaktyāvaktyāsanātana. There is another nature beyond this material nature, which is eternal. This nature is coming into existence, again dissolution. But that nature is eternal. These things are there. Similarly, their planets are also eternal. Their living entities, they are also eternal. That is called Sanatana. Sanatana means eternal, without any end, without any beginning. But this nature, as we have, this body has got a beginning and it has end. Similarly, anything, this cosmic nature has a beginning and it has an end. So, this Krishna consciousness movement is how to transfer ourselves to that nature, eternal nature.
That's man's quest.
Yes. That is the quest. Everyone is trying to be happy, because that is every living entity's prerogative. He is by nature to become happy, but he does not know where to become happy. He is trying to become happy where four things are, miserable conditions are there, namely birth, death, disease and old age. There are so many scientists, they are trying to become happy, to make people happy, but which scientist has tried to stop death, to stop old age, to stop disease? Has any scientist tried?
I don't know.
Huh? So what is this? Why do they not take consideration that we are making so much improvement? What improvement we have done about these four things? They are not. And still they are very much proud, advanced in education, science. But the four primary miserable conditions, they remain as they are. There may be advancement in medical science, but there is no medicine which can clear no more disease. Come on. Is there any medicine? Then what is that advance? Rather, disease are increasing in different forms. They have invented a nuclear weapon. What is that? To kill. Well, have you invented something so that no more man will die? That is credit. The man is dying every moment. So you have invented something to accelerate that death, that's all. Is that very, very good credit? So there is no solution up there. There is no... They are trying to stop the, I mean, say, overpopulation. But where is the solution? Every minute there are 3% increase. That is the statistic. So there is no solution for birth, there is no solution for death, there is no solution for disease, and there is no solution for old age. There was a great scientist, Professor Einstein, he also died in old age. Why did he not stop to check old age? Everyone is trying to remain youthful. Where is that process? So they do not care how to solve this, because this is beyond their means. They are giving something blah, that's all. They do not care what is the real problem, how to solve it. They do not care. Here is a movement, Krishna consciousness. That is the real solution of all problems, if people take it seriously, yes. And the whole thing is described in the Bhagavad Gita. Let them try to understand it. At least make an experiment. Why they are so much callous and in going in their own way?
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama.